Welcome to the presentation of our work Deep Learning-Based Surface Reconstruction from Binary Masks. My name is Karina Tschigor, and this work is the result of my diploma thesis carried out at Fraunhofer Mewis. What is a binary mask? A binary mask is a binary classification of an image. In this case, we have 3D medical images. There are only two possible values. All voxels belonging to the object of interest are labeled with 1. All other voxels are labeled with 0. A binary mask is the result of segmentation of, for example, tissue, organ, or vessels. It represents the volume of the object. There's no information about the exact location of the surface. There are two ways to visualize such masks: volume rendering and surface rendering. Binary masks are used in medical diagnosis, therapy planning, or treatment evaluation. To visualize a binary mask, one can use direct polygonization with a marching cube algorithm to get a surface. Here's an example of a surface reconstruction from a binary mask with marching cubes algorithm. It shows the rib cage of a human. Clearly visible are the staircase artifacts, which are a result of the limited values of a binary mask. An optimal visualization should be smooth and accurate, which means that no structures should be added or omitted. Common smoothing approaches work on the mask or on the mesh. Often large neighborhoods are required to get a smooth result. Or the approaches fail for thin or weakly connected structures. In our method, we derive a signed distance function to get better results with the marching cubes algorithm. This function has a narrow bandwidth in the range of -1 to 1 around the surface. Voxels near the surface get a value between -1 and 1, corresponding to the distance of the voxel center to the object surface. The values for the other voxels are 1 for voxels inside and -1 for voxels outside the surface. The signed distance function is calculated with a neural network based on the binary mask. Therefore, we named this function Neural Network Narrow Distance Function, NQDF. Before inference, we prepare the binary mask by changing the label for outside from 0 to -1. The output of the neural network, the NQDF, can then be polygonized with marching cubes. The result is the constructed surface, which was hidden in the binary mask. For our experiments, we need a neural network and data which is used to train and validate the network. We choose a 3D unit as the baseline architecture of our neural network. This is a convolutional neural network. Our 3D unit has 3 resolution levels, a patch size of 64 cube, and a kernel size of 3 cube. These parameters set the receptive field to a size of 44 cube. In our case, the 3D unit should perform a regression task. Hyperbolic tangent as the final layer activation function limits the output to the desired range from -1 to 1. We also need a loss function to supervise the training progress. We choose the mean squared error. This error should be minimized during the training progress. The learning rate is set to 10 to the power of -4. The neural network is ready for training. Now we need training data. We decided to use artificial data. The basic shapes we use are sphere, ellipse, cylinder, and torus. Data augmentation is achieved by anisotropic scaling and rotating of these basic shapes. Additionally, a number of spheres with small convex and concave structures on their surface are created. All surfaces are voxelized with a limited signed distance function. The voxel values are the real distances to the surface. The binary masks can be derived from this distance maps with thresholding. What we get is a dataset with pairs of binary masks and corresponding narrow signed distance maps. We split this dataset for training and validation. Validation is performed during the learning process, and the best model is saved. After training and validation of our neural network, we applied the best model on unknown binary masks. We had 5 anatomic binary masks which were obtained by segmentation from CT images of a human body. For inference, we used a computer with a graphical device with 4 GB GPU. The tile size is limited by memory and was set to 32 cubes. Depending on the size of the binary mask, the calculation of the NQDF took 19 to 91 seconds. We then calculated the distance from each voxel of the binary mask to the nearest point of the reconstructed surface. The mean error or distance over all 5 masks was 0.28 voxel diagonals. The maximum error or distance was 3.6 voxel diagonals, notably at very small structures which had only voxel size. We take the ribcage as an example for the results. It was already shown before. The binary mask of the ribcage has a size of 333 × 267 × 169 voxels. Inference time was 91 seconds. And this is the result. The surface has a very smooth impression. Larger errors can be found on very small or weakly connected structures, like in this clipping, showing a hole in a rib, which is caused by segmentation error. On the left side is the result of direct polygonization of the binary mask, which shows some additional structure missing on the right side. We applied the trained neural network on a binary mask of a liver, which has a different voxel size than the training data and the other 5 anatomic binary masks. The pictures show that the neural network also works in this case. The reconstructed surface is very smooth. The NQDF was calculated within 13 seconds. This indicates that the trained neural network is not limited to a certain voxel size of the binary mask. We now compare the polygonization of the binary mask and of the NQDF. We take again the ribcage as an example. To judge the smoothness in an objective manner, we compare the curvature of both surfaces. We therefore calculate the dihedral angle of the polygon mesh and visualize it on the surface. Small values, green, indicate less curvature. Higher values, blue, correspond to a higher curvature. On the surface on the left side, reconstructed from the binary mask, higher values are spread over the entire surface, whereas the surface on the right, reconstructed from NQDF, has mostly low values, except for structures with high curvature like the end of a rib. This proves that the NQDF improves the smoothness of the reconstructed surface. So what are the results of this work? The complexity of the reconstructed surface is similar to the direct polygonization of the binary mask. With NQDF, the smoothness of the surface is improved. There are no artifacts, but larger error for small, thin or weakly connected structures. Calculating the NQDF is very time-consuming, but is only performed once and depends on the accessible hardware, as hardware has a big influence on calculation time. What can be done in future work? Here are some proposals. Supersampling can be a solution to reduce the maximum error for small, thin or weakly connected structures. Adapted polygonization can reduce the complexity of the constructed surface. The neural network can be trained with anatomic data instead of artificial data. And also the neural network architecture or parameter can be changed to improve the NQDF. The overall conclusion is that NQDF is an already promising approach with potential for improvements. Thank you very much for your attention.